Dear colleagues, I'm Dr. Polyxeni Kechagia and I'm going to present you part of my postdoctoral research on child labor, school dropout and multinational companies. Firstly, I would like to define the purpose of the study, arguing that multinational enterprises and foreign investors consider several socio-economic and political factors when investing abroad. I focus on low labor costs. It is observed that, in certain cases, multinational enterprises tend towards unskilled workers, including minor employees. However, child labor is related to severe socio-physical consequences, among which absenteeism and school dropout. Therefore, the purpose of the research is to theoretically investigate the interaction among foreign direct investment, child labor, and school dropout in developing and developing countries through conducting a literature review. Attention is paid on education, considering that it contributes to economic growth, to the reduction of poverty, and to the improvement of a country's economy. It is noted that child labor should not be confused with certain activities such as light work after school. On the contrary, it is defined as the exploitative or illegal work of children and adolescents. As presented, mainly in the African and Asian countries, several minors do not even attend primary education. Child labor in Africa is estimated at approximately 72 million children. By national income level, as presented in the second graph, it is observed that child labor is higher in the low-income economies. Finally, as for the sectoral distribution, I will observe that agriculture presents the highest rates of child labor, since most of minor employees work within the family unit. However, why focus on child labor? Previous researches concluded that child labor is exploitative and dangerous. It could be related to sexual exploitation, corporal punishment, high rates of mortality, dropout, low rates of school enrollment, and victimization. It is interesting that in certain countries, such as India, it is not associated to chronic poverty. The methodology used in the research, as mentioned earlier, is the literature review, which is often used in modern education issues. Moreover, theoretical and empirical studies were included, as well as secondary data collected from international and reliable journals. The following table presents the findings of the literature review: the sample, the time period, the methodologies, the databases, and the variables of each study are included. Some of these studies concluded that FDI influence could affect child labor, while others reached the opposite results. In summary, contrasting findings are observed. A positive impact of foreign direct investment on child labor was observed by Deutsch et al. And Ajamir and Akaroglu. However, these findings were not in line with the rest studies of the literature review, considering that they observed a negative association between foreign direct investment and child labor. Therefore, the relation between foreign direct investment and child labor could be bidirectional, considering that, in certain cases, multinational enterprises invest their capital in countries with high rates of child labor. As for the dropout rates, it is observed that they are positively related to FDI inflows. Therefore, strengthening laws against child labor can contribute to the protection of children's rights. It is suggested that attention should be paid on the legal framework and on the education policies applied mostly in developing economies. Future studies could focus on the equilibrium of the labor market in case minor employees suddenly withdraw from multinational enterprises. Additionally, a meta-analysis could also be conducted. I would like to thank you for your attention. Comments and suggestions are always welcome.